It is also a special time for the football community, and it's unprecedented in its absence of the man who brought the world game to SBS and to our very own Australia.
Hello, I'm Liz Murray, and if you're one of the 25 million people around the world playing soccer, or one of the billions watching it, this is your station. We bring the world game home. If you're a soccer fan, there's a pretty good chance you'll have to put up with my face on this screen more often than you think.
Good evening, buonasera, welcome to the World Game.
Buenas noches, welcome.
And hello again from the World Game.
So keep it up.
I told you so, I told you so. Johnny, we're here.
This is the World Cup show coming to you from Berlin on a momentous day for football in Australia.
The 2006 FIFA World Cup.
Onward to South Africa 2010. Thank you. Thanks, everybody.
Thanks, everybody.
Bye-bye.
Lifting me higher and higher.
Yes, after 8 World Cups, the great Les Murray will watch this one from a distance with his comrade, also another great, Johnny Warren. And we may not be with him, but he is most certainly with us. And, Foz, we're going to share our memories and honour Mr. Football. Mm.
Yeah, and they are very emotional. You know, what he brought to the game and brought to the country as a refugee was all incredibly important. Of course, at his heart, the most important thing I think about Les was that he was a believer in the game, that he believed before it became cool, he believed before it became prominent, before it became mainstream. He broadcast the game and put his reputation and name behind the game before so many in Australia believed at the time when it was WOG ball. You know, now it's Australia ball. And for that, we all always remember him, you know, extremely fondly, as does all the country. So for us, it's going to be a difficult month without him. But at the same time, whilst there's been a lot of emotion around it, we also should be happy and we should celebrate what he was able to provide to the country. So for me, this month we're going to try to keep his name front and centre. We're going to make sure that his legacy is talked about, that it's protected, that Australia understands what he was about, understands what the game was about. That's what he would have wanted, in my view. Mm-hmm. What you said about him sitting upstairs would be right. You know, the memories of sitting through multiple World Cups with Les over lunch and watching all those games as he had a smoke and
a vino relaxo.
That's right.
His favourite position.
It was like watching or experiencing a World Cup with an historian. He'd been around so long and seen so much and had such a sharp memory. It was a real privilege. So we'll make sure that Les Murray, the man, Les Murray, the believer, Les Murray, the football icon, and Les Murray, the Australian, will be right at the front of all of our coverage throughout this month.
And in our hearts always. Okay, thank you, Foz. Very beautifully said. Let's